Mike Austin was born on the Isle of Guernsey, off the coast of England. At the age of six, he learned one of golf's often forgotten fundamentals from a local pro.
He says, I want you to take that Mushroom Nib Lake over there, and I want you to walk out to that big bank. He says, I want you to swing that club, and I want you to bury the head of that club into that bank, but if you come here with any mud on your sleeve, I'm gonna kick you right in your rump. I went out and I did that, but he taught me one of the greatest lessons anyone could learn, how to release the head of the club instead of hitting the wall of that bank, or, you know, with my arm and making that sleeve muddy. I hit it with a club, and that's the object of the game. You bought an instrument to hit it with. If you're not swinging the instrument, you're not making a golf swing. See, most people try to hit it basically with their body. Well, if you do so like that, you cannot have a constant swing because you're lunging at it, jumping at it, and so forth. You do not have the gracefulness, that coordination of your balance on the lower six joints to those of the upper six joints. The lower six joints incorporate ankles, knees, and hips. The upper is shoulders, elbows, and wrist. And when you do that, see, most everybody is trying to keep the spine in an upright position. I'm not looking for stability, I'm looking for mobility. Now, when I swing, my spine is swinging, but the top of my spine is still. So by having the top of my spine still, I can ground out every time at the same place. But if you move your head up and down, sideways, you'll never hit the base of the ground at the same place. So it has to be consistency. And like when you dance, you're not just trying to just dance straight, you're moving all parts of your body. You have to learn to use all 12 levers. And the more efficient you use it, more power you attain, more distance you attain.